Okay guys, so this time is punta tayo sa plane analytic geometry. So let's first tackle about points and lines. Okay, so considering meron tayo ditong X and Y axis. So this is our X axis and this is our Y axis. And let's say ito yung origin natin. And let's say ito yung points. So yung points natin is meron tayong let's say ito yung points. So this is our point 1 for instance. So this is our point 1 which we have x sub 1 and y sub 1. Okay? So yung x sub 1 na yan that corresponds to this distance. Okay? And ito yung x sub 1 natin. And ito naman yung y sub 1. So, dito talaga nag-start lahat yung formula sa plane analytic geometry. Corresponding to points and line. Ha? Then, considering meron tayo ditong another point. Okay, so bali ito yung x sub 2 natin. And ito yung y sub 2 natin. Okay? So this time yung distance na to is x sub 2. And this distance here is y sub 2. And let's say ito yung point natin. So, yung point 2 is x sub 2 yung abscisa niya and yung y sub 1 niya is yan yung ordinate. So, anyway, yung ibang pangalan pala nito, this is also called as the abscisa, yung x. Okay? Sa equation na p, x, and y. So, this is our abscisa. And this one is our ordinate. No? So the x-axis is the abscisa and the y-axis is the ordinate. Okay, so if we connect these two points, yung point 1 and point 2, we can create a line. That's it. No? So, diyan nag-start lahat. No? So, if we take yung distance nila nito. So, dito nag-start lang. Wait. What happened? Ulitin ko lang guys. Medyo may technical errors. Okay, so we're back. So nais ko lang konti. Iwan ko lang anong nangyari dun. So may kita mo dito na yung distance na ito. Ito yung tawag yan, yung difference nila nito is just yung x sub 2 minus x sub 1, no? Klarong klaro yan. And then yung dito naman is meron tayong y sub 2 minus y sub 1. So if we draw yung triangle dito, yung projecting yung mga point na yan, then we consider this triangle here. Okay, so masosolve natin yung distance. Okay, so masolve natin yung distance dyan. So may kita muna yung distance is just, if I assume this is, A and B. So distance is just, by Pythagorean theorem, is just A squared plus B squared. So therefore we have D squared is just equal, yung A natin is x sub 2 minus x sub 1 squared plus y sub 2 minus y sub 1 squared. So thus yung distance formula is just equivalent to the square root of x sub 2 minus x sub 1 squared plus y sub 2 minus y sub 1 squared. So I advise na i-memorize nyo na lang yung formula instead of deriving it. Pero actually mag-derive nyo naman, madali naman din. So at least I given you two options para ma-memorize nyo yung formula. So next is natin hahanapin is yung division of line segments. For example, i-divide natin yung line na yan into two, no? Into two line segment. Then i-derive natin yung formula doon. So for instance, ito yung pangalawang points. These points here. So I assume ito yung point. So tanggalin ko na lang daw. So ito yung point P. Assume ito yung point P at distance X and Y. So bali we assume na yung distance nito is just X and Y. So from the origin, so ito yung distance x, and corresponding naman dito, this is distance y. Okay, so if we assume na yung distance na to is let's say ito yung d1 and then ito yung distance 2, no? And then we have this total distance. Okay, so ilagay ko siya dito sa kabilang page. So meron na tayong ganito. We have point 1, x sub 1 and y sub 1. And then we have point P, x and y. And then we have point 2 na x sub 2 and y sub 2. Okay, and then ito yung distance 1, distance 2, and we have the total distance. So kung ganun pa rin, no? Kukunin pa rin natin yung triangle na to. Ayan. And also with this triangle. And then may kita natin na if I assume ito yung angle theta. Okay? So ibig sabihin na yung cosine theta. Diba? Yung cosine theta, copy ko lang ito, ha? Para masiparate ko siya. Copy and then I just paste it in other page. Okay. So ibig sabihin na yung cosine theta ng triangle na to. Tsaka yung cosine theta ng whole triangle dito are equal. Okay? Kita mo naman, no? Isang line lang sila lahat eh. So, equal sila. So, ibig sabihin na yung cosine theta is just equivalent to yung distance na to, which is na makikita mo dito na makikita mo dito na this is just x minus x sub 1 and then yung dito naman ipoproject natin yan is y minus y sub 1. So, therefore, we have x, this is x minus x sub 1, all over yung distance ito, which is x sub 2 minus x sub 1. No? Yung dito, na triangle. Ay, hindi, baliktad. Sorry. Yung distance ito. We have x sub 2 minus x sub 1. Yung ito, yung triangle. We have x sub 2 minus x sub 1, y sub 2 minus y sub 1, and then dito is y minus y sub 1. So, ibig sabihin, yung cosine theta ng dalawang triangle na yan are equal. So, x sub 1 and then x sub 2 minus x sub 1 is just equivalent to Angyari. Cosine theta ng triangle 1 is we have x minus x sub 1 all over this hypotenuse na d1. It's just equivalent to x sub 2 minus x sub 1 all over yung hypotenuse niya na d1 plus d2. So therefore we have x minus x sub 1 is just equal to d1 all over d1 plus d2 x sub 2 minus x sub 1. So yung x pala is just x sub 1 plus d1 all over d1 plus d2 x sub 2 minus x sub 1. Or we just simply say na yung x dyan, yung d1 over d1 plus d2 is just k. Okay? Then dito naman, considering yung sine theta. So yung sine theta ng triangle na to is we have y minus y sub 1 over the hypotenuse d1. And considering yung triangle na to is we have y sub 2 minus y sub 1 all over d1 plus d2. So, same procedure. So, we have y equals y1 plus d1 all over d1 plus d2 y sub 2 minus y sub 1. So, pwede natin sabihin na yung d1 all over d1 plus d2 is just k. Then, we have y sub 2 minus y sub 1. And dito naman is we have x sub 1 plus k nung x sub 2 minus x sub 1. So, yun yung formula for the division of the line segment. So, I advise na memorize nyo na lang yung formula. Okay. So, dinerive ko lang para makita nyo kung ano yung ibig sabihin ng mga points na yan. And then, mamaya pakita ko rin yung summary ng mga formulas. And then, we have a midpoint. No? Midpoint. So, yung midpoint, so, considering yung line na yan, so, we have this, again, P1, we have X sub 1 and Y sub 1. And then, dito we have x sub 2 and y sub 2. And then, dito we have p equals x and y. So, if I assume na yung mga distance in between nila are equal, so, bali midpoint yung kinukuha natin. No? Kung ito yung d total natin, so, d1 and d2 where d2 equals d1. Okay? Or, total is twice nung d1 for example. That is d1 plus d2. So, kung gagamitin natin yung formula na derive natin kanina, diba? Which is x sub 1 plus d1 all over d1 plus d2 x sub 2 minus x sub 1. So we can say that x sub 1 plus d1 all over 2d1 x sub 2 minus x sub 1, or simply say that is just 1 half no x sub 2 minus x sub 1. So pwedeng ganyan, no? Pwedeng ganyan yung way nung pagka-solve natin. Or pag-simplify pa natin yan para makita natin yung pattern, no? So we have x sub 1 plus 1 half nung x sub 2 minus x sub 1 times 2, no? So therefore that is x sub 1 divided by 2 plus x sub 2 divided by 2. So yung mangyayari ngayon is we have x sub 1 divided by 2 and y sub 1 divided by 2. So we have x1 plus x1 plus x, mali yung pagkasulat, x2 divided by 2. So therefore we have x2 divided by 2. So ito yung formula in solving for the midpoint. So ganun na din yung pattern for y. Okay, so in summary, ito na lahat yan, yung formula sa daw. So we have distance between two points, and for the line segments, ito na lang yung memorize nyo na. Basta alam mo kung ano yung value o ano na yung k. And then for the midpoint, ito naman. Okay, so yun lang guys. So continue na lang tayo sa next na video. Thank you.